This short talk, I take early Ramsey type theorems in combinatorial number theory. So I'll come to that, what are Ramsey type theorems and what are among these early Ramsey type theorems. But one can see that these many developments, big developments in the present mathematics, and Green-Tau theorem was mentioned in this morning. So all many of these things have their origin in these early Ramsey type theorems one can trace back. So the plan of the talk is like this. So here I give some names of the theorems, though it is here it is just names, but once I tell what are the statements. So the theorem of Ramsey, that many people in combinatorics will be familiar with Ramsey's theorem, and there are some other results of Suhr, van der Waarden and Hilbert, and some of these theorems actually came before this Ramsey's theorem, but after Ramsey's theorem was there. In fact, rightly speaking, after Ramsey's theorem was rediscovered by Erdos Jekares and it was popularized, then people with hindsight could see the unifying feature of several of the early Ramsey type theorems of these, which include this Suhr, van der Waarden, etc. So let me tell what is the, this is the planning of the lecture. Some general philosophy. The general philosophy is that when a structure is there in So the general philosophy of Ramsey theorem is like Ramsey type theorems like that. Suppose you have a structure, most often we come with the statement that if the structure is divided into finitely many parts, one of the parts will retain some of the regularity properties of the original structure. Here I am a bit vague, but once we see the statements, then one can see what I mean by this. But there are cases where if I take, there is a structure and I take a portion of it which is big in some way, I can give examples of this also, that what do I mean by big. So then this certain big, if it is big in some way, in some situation, it can retain some of the regularities of the original structure. So this is the general philosophy I have already told, and here the quotation of Theodore Modgkin, which is often quoted to express this philosophy of Ramsey type theorems, that complete disorder is impossible. Because if something is happens very irregularly, then the irregularity start occurring regularly. So that is the philosophy. So here is the pigeonhole principle that is taught in school. So I am just telling it again, that if n plus 1 objects are put in n pigeonholes, then there will be one pigeonhole containing more than one object. This is a counting argument, that if each of them had not more than one, then we could not have more than. So there is this well-known example that if you have a party of at least 6 people, then you can guarantee that there will be a group of 3 people who, here the knowing means I make it knowing both ways, because you may know the Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, he may not know me. It is not like that. So some people give shaking hand, so where it is happens mutually. So if 3 people who all know each other or none of them know each other, in the, so that is possible, that is in graph theoretically, the proof goes by like that. So if you take one A, we separate out this A, that I take A, I join to other 5 points, and I decide this knowing and not knowing by red and blue. So because of pigeonhole principle, since there are 5 lines and two category I divide them, red and blue. So at least three of them will be upon color. So without loss of generality, let us assume three red color happens. But now because these two are red, if this had been red, we would be through. So let us put it blue. Similarly, since this and F, these are red, so this we are forced to put blue to avoid a red triangle. Similarly, to avoid a red triangle ACF, we put CF blue. But finally, we end up getting FADC, this triangle is blue. So that is the, but then here it is very easy, but one can check that with five things it cannot be done. So sixth is the exact minimal number of points needed to have this sort of occurrence, that either a red triangle or a blue triangle, which in this, the way we said knowing and not knowing or handshaking, it can be translated into. But one should know that this calculating, because I will make the general statement of Ramsay, there the calculation is very difficult. So what is Ramsay's theorem? I give a simple version here, that K, R and L are positive integers, where L we have to assume greater than or equal to K, otherwise the statement will be vacuous. Then there exists a positive integer N depending on these three parameters, such that when you have R coloring, so here I have coloring two colors, blue and red, so that means partitioning into two parts. So similarly, if we have so K subsets, so here we are having two subsets. So two subsets, either the pair of points where the edge denotes that pair of points. So similarly here we have K subsets, K element subsets of the set, that square bracket N is just 1, 2, 3 up to N. So then there is an L subset, L element subset, all of whose K element subsets are of the same color. So if you look back to the problem we said, that was that we are coloring by two colors and we are wanted to have a three subset, all of whose two subsets are of the same color. So this is Ramsay's theorem guarantees that this is true for every K, R and L, where L is greater than or equal to K, then we will have K subsets of a L size, otherwise we will not have, so we take L greater than or equal to K. But here is a theorem of Suhr. But you notice that Ramsay's theorem was in 1930 and Ramsay also died very young, I mean he was about 27 and before this paper was published posthumously. Ramsay had two papers, one in economics, one in logic, and this is a lemma in that logic, which is now there is a subject in his name. So here is Suhr's theorem 1916. Suhr's theorem also was a lemma. Actually there was a famous, of course everybody knows this Fermat's last theorem, that the equation x to the power n plus y to the power n equal to z to the power n doesn't have solution where n is greater than or equal to 3. Now there were those days it was not known and people tried to see whether counter examples or something, so the always both ways they were trying. And what it was found that, so Suhr didn't prove this result first, this was already known in 8 years before, that if give me any n, I have a capital N, so you give me n, I have a capital N, such that whenever that n is greater than or equal to n, p is greater than or equal to n, p is a prime, then x to the power n plus y to the power n is equal to z to the power n mod p has a solution. So usually what one proves, that to show that some mod p there is no solution, then you can show that there is no solution. But here it turned out different way, that you take n, n greater than or equal to, of course for 2 there is anyway, there are solutions, Pythagorean triples, so usually you take n greater than or equal to 3, then fix, take this equation, x to the power n plus y to the power n equal to z to the power n, then given this n, there is a capital N which is a function of small n, such that when you take any prime p greater than n, then mod p solution, meaning this x to the power, there are x, y, z, such that x to the power n plus y to the power n minus z to the power n is divisible by p. So, this result was a new proof was given by Suhr, and where Suhr used this result. What is that if you R color the set of positive integers, meaning if you set make the partition into three parts of the set of positive integers, then in one part there will be x, y and z satisfying the equation x plus y equal to z. And this, of course, as you can guess, can be used to prove this, that you take the nth powers mod p, the subgroup in z mod p z star, and then you work and then the take the cosets as the different colors, and you get a this thing, this answer. Of course, when Suhr proved this, then Ramsey's theorem was not available, and he did in a difference technique, that is a difference method taking successive differences, and he had a in fact a size also. So, if you have this number of colors, that division, that where is that, I have not gone below, that R, so depending on R, where is that, so depending on R, he had a size, that size was that E into factorial R integral part, okay. This was that his size, but now the way I will show that Ramsey's theorem implies that, and there also if you know the corresponding Ramsey numbers, more or less one gets the same bound, that E has been recently improved little bit, but otherwise we stay here. So, let capital N be small n 2 r 3, where k is equal to 2 and l is equal to 3, okay, as we have defined in Ramsey's theorem. So, you take 3 element sets and get monochromatic 2 element subsets. So, suppose you take a coloring from the set of these integers 1 2 3 up to capital N to 1 to R. Okay. Now, from there I induce a coloring on the 2 element sets, because I have color on the integers, now I put colors on the pairs of integers. How? That this chi star of this pair I define to be chi of the difference of I minus, okay, mod. So, that is, of course, it is already I have defined on this, so chi is available. So, that is, now by definition a 3 element subset there will be, such that any 2 element subset will have same chi star. But what is that? By our construction, this is nothing but chi of b, because a less than b less than c. So, b minus a is mod b minus a. So, chi b minus a equal to chi c minus b, chi c minus a. But see, this automatically satisfies this. So, these three colors are same and they satisfy this equation. So, that is the thing. So, now, so we see that Ramsey's theorem implies Suhr's result. Okay. So, now I will tell this subject another result, which is van der Waarden. So, this is van der Waarden is one of the results which Kinchin put in. Kinchin wrote a letter to a soldier in the First World War, and he was wounded in the camp. So, he was a mathematics student, so he wrote some three results in mathematics, and he gave the name, there is a book available now on these three pulse of number theory, and one of the pulse was this theorem, van der Waarden theorem. And as we will see, if I have time, 5-10 minutes I can spend at some point, how this, that further generalizations today we have come to Green Tau theorem. So, now van der Waarden theorem was also 1927, it was also before the result of Ramsey, and it says that given positive integers k r, there exists a van der Waarden number w k r, such that once we take go 1 2 3 up to w k r and divide them into r parts, then one part will contain an arithmetic progression of length k. So, what is an arithmetic progression of length k? A a plus b, a plus k minus 1 b. So there is an arithmetic progression of length k will be sitting in one of them. So because I'll do away with this, then I lose track of what I'm telling. So the thing is, there are several generalizations of both these themes. Okay, so here what I say, that x plus y equal to z, so you can write it x plus y minus z. This equation has a monochromatic solution. If you take all the set of positive integers, one, two, take all of them now. Okay, so any finite partition, if you do, that means if you color them in finitely many colors, this is red, this is green, this is blue, as long as you are using finitely many colors, you will get a monochromatic solution of this equation, meaning x, y, z of the same color satisfying this. There is another one, like that you take this three term arithmetic progression van der Waerden, so that is x minus 2y plus z is equal to 0, because an arithmetic progression x, y, z will satisfy this equation, so that is this equation. So now there is a generalization, that what about a1 x1, an xn is equal to 0. So there is a Rado's theorem which has a solution, I will not go into that, about a system of linear equations when it is regular. Regular meaning for every finite coloring there is a monochromatic solution. And that is if and only if there exists some set I, non-empty, of the index set 1, 2 up to n, such that when you sum them, ai, I belonging to I is 0. So meaning what? That sum of the coefficients sum up to 0. So here take this one and this minus 1, 0. Here take 1, minus 2 and this one, all the coefficient sum is 0, and that is if and only if. So this is one generalization, and then there are further generalizations, if time permits I will come to that. But then there are other things. This is one direction of, and that has come very far, because there are many other things, that here, like that when you say that x, y and x plus y are of the same color, when you say that this is a monochromatic solution, that same meaning is that x, y and x plus y are of the same color. This is same as x plus y equal to z is monochromatic, is can be said like that. So then there are things that when that you go on increasing, you get bigger, bigger sets with this property. So I'll not go into that, I'll go to the next theme. There is a difference between this van der Waerden's theorem and Schur's theorem in one aspect. This was observed that, see, what about density thing? Density meaning that natural density I'll define. So take any subset A of the set of positive integers. So you take, these are the set of positive integers, and you take some of the elements. So there is, take this intersection up to n, okay, 1, 2, up to n, how many elements are there in A, by n, and take Lim sup, okay, as n tends to infinity, okay. Now if we take all the even integers and odd integers, they both have this upper natural density half. But one can clearly see that this equation doesn't have a solution in the odd integers. On the other hand, Erdos and when it was, if you take the van der Waerden's theorem, then it was observed by several people, but then it was written as a conjecture by Erdos and Turan. That van der Waerden's theorem has nothing to do with this partition and all. So if you take a set of subset of positive integers such that Lim sup, this, that let me define this so I don't have to write again. This is written d bar a positive upper-natural density. So if you have positive upper-natural density, this positive, then this implies a contains arithmetic progression of arbitrary length. So that means you give me k, I find arbitrary progression of length k, then you give me another k, bigger some l, then I go somewhere else, I find, suppose I give example, you take this 1, then leave 2, then you take 3, 4, then leave 4, then you take leave 3, I have left here 2, then leave 2 here, so 4, then 5, 6, you leave 7, 8, 9, so then leave 4 and take 5, leave 5 and take 6, like that if you take, then here I have an arithmetic progression of length 3, at some point I will have an arithmetic length 4 and so on and so forth. So this was the conjecture of Erdős-Turan, and this was first solved by Zemeredy. Okay, by a very difficult combinatorial method. By the way, Zemeredy's result, Zemeredy is in computer science department in Rutgers. He considers himself as a computer scientist, and he solved that, and that paper gave many ideas which are used in many things. Okay, many lemmas are main tools in many things. And then there was a Fürstenberg gave one ergodic theoretic proof, and that opened up a ergodic Ramsey theory. And then there is another conjecture of Erdős which is wide open. Okay, take some set of positive integers a1, a2, a3, like this, such that the reciprocals, some of the reciprocals diverge. n is equal to 1 to infinity, okay, is equal to infinity. If the sum of the reciprocals diverge, then this set will have arbitrary long arithmetic progression. That question is open, and what is now proved, one knows that sigma 1 by p primes diverges. So, and that is Green-Tau theorem. But here, of course, that there is a prime gap, okay, Goldstone-Ildarin prime gap result was crucially used. So it is not just this gap, but that prime gap, so you had to use something which is, because here also, if you do this sigma 1 by p less than equal to x, it is about log x. So it should grow that fast. So it doesn't say about this can go even much slowly, so then we don't know. So that will be very, even this itself is so difficult. So this will be very, very difficult. So this is open. Similarly, I will mention one open question also, that we know that the equation x plus y is equal to z is regular, meaning given any finite coloring of the set of positive integers, there is a monochromatic solution of this. But what about this equation, x square plus y square equal to z square? Is it regular? Nobody knows. So this is open. So with this, I stop, but I am around, so we can talk sometime in this way. Thank you very much.
I have one question.
Yeah.
This is with respect to, you initially remarked that there is a structure larger in every sufficiently large set. There is a certain structure.
Structure means that is having, if you take the all set of positive integers, then give me any k, I can find arithmetic progression in that. Yeah, so similarly, here you divide a finitely many parts, however many divide, 10, 20, 100, one part will be like this, that you will have whatever arithmetic progression length you give me, I will find a big arithmetic progression in that.
I am interested actually in something which is maybe not directly connected.
Uh-huh.
One of the biggest challenges in information processing and is to understand biological systems and certain types of methods used in algorithms, heuristics. They are all dynamical systems of a very high order. Now, if you take a random dynamical system, I really do know it's very hard for us to understand what happens. Certainly, there are very general theorems saying that there is a stable manifold, there is an unstable manifold, and things of this kind. but we need far more structure than this. Are you aware of any applications of it? Looks like this theory, when appropriately generalized, may
have, because you may find that some smoothness somewhere, something like that. Because see, there are some other generalization in higher dimension, that suppose you color all the lattice points, then you give me these points, you may not find this sort of thing monochromatic physics somewhere, but you can find a translated homotheory which looks like this. And so physics people have used this in spin up, spin down. So they get a spin up, spin down, whatever shape you give, same sort of shape, but not in same place, but in a expanded area, that sort of. But I don't know that this sort of geometry, it has not come up to that. So everything now, it is in discrete level, it is there. In the manifold level, nothing is, I don't know.
Yeah, because I looked at a model of a cell. 100 coupled nonlinear differential equation.
Yeah.
What is the insight?
Yeah.
You can numerically solve
yeah,
it.
Yeah.
Far more so, power.
Yeah. Because whatever parameter you need, maybe few, everything cannot be anyway given.
Yeah.
So these are very complicated. So because
bifurcation theory in one dimension, two dimensions, and so on.
No, here also they use some sort of dynamics. Yeah. So suppose you have a continuous map on a compact thing, then there will be some recurrent point.
Okay.
So that they used. So you have to find a proper topology, and it should be compactness should be there, and then there should be continuous map. So it will have some property. So like that, some point will coming back to the orbit infinitely often, like that. So okay.
Sir, kindly appreciate the student.
Oh.